All right, let's talk togging. I'm gonna start with probably my least favorite setup, probably the one that I use the least. This is a simple high-low. As you can see, starting with the business end, Shimano reel, 50-pound braid. Almost always we'll put about a 6-foot top shot of 40 or 50-pound fluorocarbon, come down to either a loop. In this case, I've got a clip. This clip is a rather large clip, as you can see, and that's so we can put any size sinker on. If we got light tide, shallow water, or heavy tide and deep water, we can go from light to heavy sinkers with this size clip. Just up above that, you can see I put a dropper loop in. In this case, I had a small eye on the hook, so I had to cut the dropper loop so I could make it into a single strand and simply tied off this 4-0 Gamakatsu J hook. It's an octopus J hook with a uni knot. The use of the high-low rig comes in handy when you're in really heavy structure and you want to just touch the bottom with the sinker and keep the hook above it. Obviously, I could move this hook up or down on the leader. My big thing is presentation with the tog. They don't worry too much about the terminal tackle. So the closer you can be to the bottom where they naturally pick crabs up off of, the better shape you're in and the more you'll catch. That's the high-low rig. Again, it's not my favorite of the three. It's my least favorite, but it does have its applications. So moving along to my second favorite, more of a recent phenomena, is the tog jig. Very similar to a bucktail jig, but obviously without the feather. The tog jig is extremely effective in shallow water and slow current. As you can see, I only have about 2 or 3 ounces of lead. So therefore I can't, in 1.5, 2.5 knot current, I can't use this. It's simply just gonna wash away. But as the tide slackens out, as the water isn't moving as much, it makes a much better presentation. Now the old tog, they got old because they're wise. They don't eat what doesn't look like a crab. This looks most effectively like a natural crab presentation. It sits on the bottom. We usually put a whole crab over the top with the top shell removed, and it is deadly. When the tide slackens and you can get it down the bottom and properly present it, the tog jigs are awesome. I've got this on a spinning rod. Again, 50, 65 pound braid. And I got a Shimano Saragossa. We've got 4, 5, 6 foot leader of 40 pound fluorocarbon right to a tog jig. And that's why I've got a spinning rod on, because usually we fish tog jigs in very light current, usually slack tide or shallow water. Also at slack tide, we'll work the tog jig on the bottom and we'll use the spinning rod or the conventional to give it a little bit of action. Just get it moving just a little bit, wiggling on the bottom, and that really entices a bite. Moving along to my favorite, most widely used setup, I've got an Avid reel here, which is probably overkill, but again, 50 or 65 pound braid. We use 50 or 65 pound braid because we can break it off if we need to. You don't need to go to 80 or 100 pound braid. Then when you get stuck in the bottom, you're gonna have a really hard time breaking it if you've got a heavy leader. So 50 or 65 pound braid, right to, again, 40, 50 pound, 6 foot fluorocarbon leader, and right to all terminal tackle. So this is a simple three-way swivel, and then I've got a clip that we buy. All of this separately, we buy the Gamakatsu 4-0 or 3-0 J hooks, octopus J hooks, the three-way swivel, and the clips all separately. Again, you can see it's a rather large clip. We're gonna put 8, 10, 12 ounce sinkers on sometimes. And you can also see that the dropper on this one is relatively short. What I tell Ryan on the boat all the time is that if your fingers aren't cramping up when you're tying these on, there's a problem. The shorter the better. If you think about it, if there's a long drop, the crab is sitting out there, the fish are picking it up and eating on it, you're not even feeling it. So the shorter the drop from the three-way to the hook, the better. This one's okay for decent current, and really light current, I'd shorten it up even more. Caught monster fish on this. Is just a simple three-way swivel, a clip for the weight, and a nice sharp hook. Use a sinker that's heavy enough that it's not getting pushed around with the tide. So we often change our sinkers out as the tides increase, as the tides decrease. We'll go heavier with a heavier tide, lighter with a lighter tide. Still presentation, having it sitting still on the bottom and waiting for the fish to come to you is extremely important. And this setup right here is about as cheap as you can get. It's about as good as you can get. The chum pot. This is another key component of togging. We usually crush up crabs, put frozen clams in here. As you can see, there's a 6 pound deep drop weight in there. Fill this sucker right up. You want it to be as vertical as possible off the bow of the boat so you get the chum moving back through the tide and through the areas where you're fishing. It'll improve your fishing probably 90% of the time. There's three key things when it comes to tautog fishing, and that's location, location, location. And this is what holds you in that location. Two anchors is better than one. One will get the job done, but you need to have the proper size anchor for the boat you're fishing. Today we're fishing a 23 foot maritime skiff, so I got a relatively small anchor. You can see I've already bent the shank trying to get it loose. You got to have a proper amount of chain. I like heavy chain. This is what holds it on the bottom, so you drag it and get it caught. We'll fish anywhere from 4 foot to 120 foot of water for tautog. So we got plenty of line here, and we also got backup line. So if you think you want a tautog fish here and the tide's coming at you, usually drive into the tide or the wind or the combination of that. You check your drift. If you think you want to fish right here, you better go way up here and drop the anchor. That's why we bring the extra line. Drop the anchor ahead of the area you want to fish. You can always drop back more, and there will always be adjustment. The first place that you anchor when you tautog fish will highly likely not be the last place you anchor. So you need to have an anchor that's light enough that you can deploy it and retrieve it easily, and you can move around if need be. You also need plenty of line, so once you do get that hook set, you can drop back, you can move up, you can change position. You need to move around. 20, 30 minutes, if you're not catching, move. That's the key when it comes to tautog fishing. Those are some of our methods and techniques for tautog fishing. If you enjoyed watching this video, make sure you like and subscribe down below. And if you have any questions or comments, make sure you leave them below and we'll get right back to you. Thanks for watching.